Welcome to worship. It is good to see you all this morning. Good to have you with us. I am Pastor Amber. This is Prince of Peace Lutheran Church in Clifton Park, New York. And we are happy to have you here this morning. A couple of quick things as we get started. Today we are using our contemporary musicians, and so we'll have a couple of contemporary pieces throughout the service. Also, a thank you to Deacon Jim Netzer for preaching this morning. It was a wonderful week to accomplish many things for me that didn't include preaching, so it's a nice break every once in a while, so thank you for that, Deacon Jim. And also, I wanted to let you know as we begin worship this morning that at our early service, our in-person service, we did say farewell and Godspeed to the Price family. To Dave and Shelley and Susanna and William and Catherine and Sarah. They are moving to New Mexico this next week, so we wish them well. We prayed for them and with them, and our prayers go with them as they begin a new chapter of their lives. I think that's all I have to share with you as we get started, and so I invite you to join me in the words of our purpose statement, as we remind ourselves who God has called us to be in this time and place. Claimed by grace, we seek to welcome all, worship joyfully, grow spiritually, and share God's love. We continue with the greeting, the prayer of the day, and a prayer of confession and the assurance of pardon. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you always. Let us pray. Righteous God, our merciful Master, you own the earth and all its peoples, and you give us all that we have. Inspire us to serve you with justice and wisdom, and prepare us for the joy of the day of your coming. Through Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord. Amen. Blessed be the Holy Trinity, one God, in whose image we are made, who claims us and calls us beloved. Amen. Let us confess our sin in the presence of God and of one another. Holy One, we confess that we are not awake for you. We are not faithful in using your gifts. We forget the least of our siblings. We do not see your beautiful image in one another. We are infected by sin that divides your beloved community. Open our hearts to your coming. Open our eyes to see you in our neighbor. Open our hands to serve your creation. Amen. Beloved, we are God's children, and Jesus, our beloved, opens the door for us. Through Jesus, we are forgiven. By Jesus, we are welcomed. In Jesus, we are called to rejoice. Let us live in the promises prepared for us from the foundation of the world. Amen. Our gathering song today is Power of Your Love.
Thank you. the knowledge of your love has you built in me. Lord, unveil my mind as your will unfolds in my life, in living every day, by the power of draw me to your side, and as I wait, I'll rise up like the eagle, and I will soar with you. Your spirit leads me on in the power of your love. Oh, draw me to your side, and as I wait, I'll rise up like the eagle, and I will soar with you. Your spirit leads me on in the power of your love.
Good morning. I never saw a moor. I never saw the sea. Yet know I how the heather looks and what a wave must be. I never spoke with God nor visited in heaven. Yet certain am I of the spot as if the chart were given. That is part of a poem by the famous Emily Dickinson. Emily Dickinson, as an adult, rarely left her house. She was a recluse. She wrote nearly 2,000 poems in her lifetime, yet only 5 of them were published while she was alive. It was her sister who, after Emily's death, found all of her poems and published them in a book after she died. So Jesus tells us a story today about hiding our talents. He tells us of a man who calls 3 of his servants to him because he is going away for a while. He gave one man 5 talents, another man 2 talents, and one man 1 talent. He gave them each enough according to their abilities. When he got back, he was very pleased with the first 2 because they had doubled their talents. And the 3rd man, he was very angry with him because he had hid away his talent, kind of like Emily Dickinson did with her poems. The master was very angry because the 3rd man did not put his talent to good use. But he was very pleased with the 2 who used their talent and doubled it. God wants us to use the talents or gifts that we have been given by Him so that others can benefit from them. Are you a writer? Then send letters to people. Write a poem. Write a story. Are you an artist? Draw pictures for your neighbors. Send them to friends and family. Are you good with computers? I know a lot of people who could use help right now with their computers. So help your friends. Let us pray. I'll say it and you can repeat after me. Dear God, thank you for each individual here. Thank you for each of our different talents. Teach us to be happy with the gifts you have given us. And help us use these talents to your glory. Amen. Children of God, let your light so shine before others that they may see your good works and glorify your Father in heaven. Amen.
Though we do not know and cannot calculate the day of Christ's return, the Apostle Paul implores us to live faithfully in the here and now as we anticipate the day when we will be given eternal salvation through our Lord Jesus Christ.
A reading from 1 Thessalonians. Now, concerning the times and the seasons, brothers and sisters, you do not need to have anything written to you. For you yourselves know very well that the day of the Lord will come like a thief in the night. When they say, there is peace and security, then sudden destruction will come upon them, as labor pains come upon a pregnant woman, and there will be no escape. But you, beloved, are not in darkness, for that day to surprise you like a thief. For you are all children of light and children of the day. We are not of the night or of the darkness. So then let us not fall asleep as others do, but let us keep awake and be sober. For those who sleep, sleep at night, and those who are drunk, get drunk at night. But since we belong to the day, let us be sober and put on the breastplate of faith and love, and for a helmet, the hope of salvation. For God has destined us not for wrath, but for obtaining salvation through our Lord Jesus Christ, who died for us, so that whether we are awake or asleep, we may live within him. Therefore, encourage one another and build up each other, as indeed you are doing. Here ends the reading.
In our gospel reading this morning, Jesus tells a parable about his second coming, indicating that it is not sufficient merely to maintain things as they are, for those who await his return should make good use of the gifts that God has provided them. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew, the 25th chapter. Jesus said to the disciples, "For it is as if a man going on a journey summoned his slaves and entrusted his property to them. To the first he gave 5 talents, to another 2, to another 1, each according to his ability, and then he went away. The one who had received the 5 talents went off at once and traded with them and made 5 more talents. In the same way, the one who had the 2 talents made 2 more talents. But the one who had received the 1 talent went off and dug a hole in the ground and hid his master's money. After a long time, the master of those slaves came and settled accounts with them. Then the one who had received the 5 talents came forward, bringing 5 more talents, saying, 'Master, you handed over to me 5 talents. See, I've made 5 more talents. His master said to him, "Well done, good and trustworthy slave. You have been trustworthy in a few things. I will put you in charge of many things. Enter into the joy of your master." And the one with the 2 talents also came forward, saying, "Master, you handed me 2 talents, and I have made 2 more talents. His master said to him, "Well done, good and trustworthy slave. You have been trustworthy in a few things. I will put you in charge of many things. Enter into the joy of your master." And then the one who had received the 1 talent also came forward, saying, "Master, I knew where you were a harsh man, reaping where you did not sow, and gathering where you did not scatter seed. So I was afraid, and I went and hid your talent in the ground. Here, you can have what is yours." But his master said, "You wicked and lazy slave, you knew, did you, that I reap where I did not sow and gather where I did not scatter? Then you ought to have invested my money with the bankers, and on my return I would have received what was my own with interest. So take the talent from him and give it to the one with the 10 talents. For to those that have more will be given, and they will have an abundance. But those who have nothing, even what they have will be taken away. As for this worthless slave, throw him into the outer darkness, where there'll be weeping and gnashing of teeth. This is the gospel of the Lord. May the words of my mouth and the meditation of my heart be found pleasing to you, O Lord, my rock and my redeemer. Remember back when you were a kid and you got a paper back from your teacher, whether it was an assignment or a test or a quiz or even homework, and it had one of those gold stars on it? You felt pretty darn good about it, didn't you? And so did your parents. Conversely, maybe there was a time when there was a parent-teacher's night and your parents were told that you were smart and had the ability, but you just didn't seem to apply yourself. Consequently, your parents weren't happy, And so you weren't happy with the quote-unquote lecture that you received once you got home. Funny thing is, we sometimes have similar situations throughout our lives, whether it involves us, our parents, or our kids, or anything. And it doesn't matter what the particular situation is. The bottom line is that chances are it is frustrating, and you find yourself saying, woulda, coulda, shoulda. 2020 hindsight is great, but 2020 foresight, in most cases, would have been much better. And that might have helped out the third servant in today's gospel reading. More about that in a moment. First, a little background. It's probably best to allegorically picture the wealthy landowner as, of all things, a wealthy landowner and not of God, because God obviously would not be reaping where God did not sow and gathering where God did not scatter seed. Another thing to consider is the talents mentioned in the reading. They do not represent somebody's abilities, whether it be artistic, like singing, dancing, acting, or everyday practical talents, like being handy with tools and the ability to fix things or even electronic. But as Diana said, those things are very helpful if you do any of those things for your neighbor. A talent that Matthew, the gospel reader, was talking about was money. Not just money. Money! Big money! A talent is equal to about 6,000 denarii. And if you've reached in your pocket and counted how many denarii you have, well, you probably don't have anything because they're not really available anymore. But I will tell you that one denarius was a common laborer's daily wage. And a talent, well, that would roughly be equivalent to 20 years for the average worker. So 20 years of wages, not too shabby. So that would mean that the third servant was given 20 years worth of wages. Now I'm going to be a little bit conservative on this and say that as a day laborer, maybe he made $25,000 a year. Okay, do the math. That works out to $500,000 that third servant was given. Okay, for those that don't want to do the math, we'll do the other guys too. That would mean that the second servant was given a tidy sum of $1 million. And the first servant, well, a mere $5 million. Okay, back to the third servant. As you recall, he buried that talent. That's another way of saying he forgot about it, put it out of his mind. He knew the master would return someday, but not right away. So, out of sight, out of mind. And maybe we can better understand the parable a little bit better if we think of talents as not being about personal abilities or even money, but rather faith and the responsibility that faith entails. Because if you think about it, faith is more than simply a statement of beliefs. Faith is a verb, not a noun. Theologian Reverend Anthony Robinson puts it this way, quote, "The first two servants do use the money entrusted to them. They put their faith to work. The third, with a lesser but still a very large amount, buries it and tries to forget about it, burial being a symbol of forgetting. And then he tries to forget that a great thing has been entrusted to his care. Why? Well, because if he took it seriously and acknowledged its reality, it could utterly change his life. He doesn't want that. Doesn't want to be responsible or take risks. Doesn't want joy." Unquote. Another way of looking at that parable is, if you see that the slaves are supposed to imitate their master, knowing what the master expected of them. And the ones who did what their master did were rewarded. The one who thought of only his own interest, well, we heard about that not so joyful ending of the weeping and the gnashing of teeth. But basically, it all comes down to one has to know what to expect and what is expected of you. So if you enter into things with a fear of taking any kind of responsibility, like the third slave, well, you'll really get something to fear about in return as a result. Dietrich Bonhoeffer adds, quote, "The sin of respectable people is running away from responsibility," unquote. Ouch, that kind of hurts. Yet we have often been encouraged to step out in faith. When push comes to shove, do we? Does the promise of God's amazing grace ever enter into our decision? Sure, it might be risky, it might be scary. Lord knows it probably won't be easy, and you may not even see the results of your labors. But wait, here's the thing. We have gifts. We all have gifts, spiritual gifts. Gifts to do God's work here and now. In the preceding chapter of Matthew, we are reminded that all who follow Jesus are to preach the good news to the kingdom, to the whole world, by going about the work that the Master has called them to do. Brothers and sisters in Christ, that's faith in action. You can anticipate that it won't always be easy, especially since nothing of lasting value ever is. But what would you do with that faith, that precious gift that is worth far more than any amount of money that you can think of, even the ridiculous amounts that are represented in Matthew's gospel reading today? Well, there are two choices according to this parable. You can either use the faith you have and preach the good news to others who need to hear it. And by the way, this is no secret. You don't need words to do that. Or, don't want to do that? You can bury it, forget about it. Maybe bring it out for an hour on a Sunday morning. Although when Judgment Day comes, would we want to hear Jesus say something like, well, you had the God-given ability, but you just didn't apply yourself. Or if you stepped out of faith, took the risks, took the responsibility, and applied your, and used your God-given abilities, and then hear Jesus say to you, well done, good and faithful servant. And hearing that is worth far more than any gold star, or even all the gold and riches in the world. Because God's joy would last for an eternity. And the choice is up to each one of us. Woulda, coulda, shoulda. And you know, it all starts with that little light of yours and mine. Question is, are you going to let it shine like a gold star? Amen.
We have heard the word of the Lord proclaimed. Let us join together in the Apostles' Creed. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord. He was conceived by the power of the Holy Spirit and born of the Virgin Mary. He suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended into hell. On the third day, he rose again. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen. The prayers of the church will be read responsively. When I say, Lord, in your mercy, please respond with, hear our prayer. Longing for Christ's reign to come among us, we pray for the outpouring of God's power on the church, the world, and all in need. We pray for guidance and wisdom for our bishops, John and Elizabeth, for our pastor, Amber, and all those serving in positions of leadership. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Lord of creation, we stand in awe at the works of your hands and praise you for the beauty of nature. Bless the earth for your glory and restore its integrity where exploitation has caused ruin. Hear us, O God. We pray for all the ministries here at Prince of Peace and lift up in prayer all those who serve in God's name throughout the world. We pray especially for the EFES program in Chile, the children supported by our Sunday school, Oscar, Albertina, and Rodrigo. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Lord of all in need, search out all who cry to you in distress. Scatter the heavy clouds of depression, chronic illness, unemployment, and loneliness with your radiant light. Send us as encouragement and signs of your healing. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. We pray especially for healing for Kathy, Jim, Sarah, Greg, Jen, Art, Lenny, Paul, Bill, Val, Steve, Breezy, Barbara, Anita, Christopher, Hank, Kit, Kurt, Marilyn, Don, Betty, Sal, Veronica, Erica, Tom, Doug, and Eileen. We ask for positive test results for Jim. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. We pray for all of our nation's troops serving throughout the world, especially those in harm's way, and for their families and friends back home. We ask you, Lord, for strength and comfort for Barb, Hal, Helen, Anne, Lauren, Elsa, Susan, for those in Central America as they brace for Hurricane Iota. And we ask for thanksgiving for the healing of Sarah. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. And now, Father in heaven, in this moment of silence, we offer our hopes, our concerns, our joys, and our sorrows that only you can see and feel in our hearts. Into your hands, O Lord, we commend all for whom we pray, trusting in your mercy through our Savior, Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen.
As at least two of those servants in our reading today made use of the things that their master had given them, we make use of what God has given us. And one of the ways that we do that is to give, to share what we have with organizations that are making a difference in the world. If one of those organizations that you like to give to is Prince of Peace, thank you. And you can do that via the Give Plus app, our website, or by mailing a check to the church. But thank you for your giving. Today I want to thank you for the support you give that allows us to do a lot of really special projects, special giving around the holidays. From the confirmation class supporting a family at the St. Paul Center, to our collection for local hunger needs, to the Advent Conspiracy, these are all ways that we give above and beyond in this season. So thank you for helping to meet the needs of those around us, the local, and the needs beyond with your support. I'm gonna try and do communion at the altar today, and if the sound is really bad, just let us know. But I'm gonna turn my mic on, and hopefully with the new sound and everything, it will work great. As we gather as a people of faith together, we hear. strengthen you, and keep you in his grace. Amen. Just a couple of quick announcements to share with you this morning. Next week, we will be having a congregational meeting. It's our annual November congregational meeting. Oop, there we go. I'm going to turn that off. It's a short meeting. It's very brief. We're going to start it at the first service, the in-person service, and then we're going to continue it in a Zoom meeting instead of our regular coffee hour. Now, the way this works is that if you're going to join us for the Zoom meeting, you can either join the Zoom meeting via the link you'll get in an email, or by following the password and the meeting number that will be at the end of the service. Or if you don't have access to Zoom in that way, you can also just call. There'll be a number in the email that's a phone number. And you can just call the phone number and put in all the information it asks for, which will also be in the email. And then you can just call and listen. And you can talk, and you can listen, and you can make your voice heard and your vote count. Any of those ways will work as we have this very unorthodox meeting, but we need to have a meeting. Primarily, the whole purpose of this meeting is to elect members to council and also Synod Assembly representatives. If you would like to serve in either of those capacities, as a member of council or as a representative to the Synod Assembly in June, you can talk to our little nominating committee, which is Rob Anderson, Jim Galarno, or Christine Shepherd. These are important positions in our church. They're a lot of fun. We do our best to keep council meetings enjoyable and timely. We do our best to have a really great time at Synod Assembly. So if you are at all interested in these positions, you can talk with one of those three people, Rob Anderson, Jim Galarno, Christine Shepherd, and they can give you more information. And also, if you want to put your name on the ballot, they can get that situated for you as well. We are looking for some tech help to get these services, continue to keep these services running. Right now, between my husband and I, we're doing a lot of the work. So we're looking for some people who are able to put together a PowerPoint or update a PowerPoint. Most of the work is done, but to update it every week for our first service. And then also to work with this service. The software we use is called OBS. I can't tell you what it stands for, but it is a software that with a little work, you can learn. It's not hard, it just takes a little getting used to. And then mostly it just needs updated each week and then brought to church to be used for the service. If you are interested in either of those, or if you're interested in being somebody who can push the button to run it, do let me know. Our hope is that we can get some people trained for this so that it doesn't always fall on me, but also so that when I go on maternity leave, we can continue to have a level of service and technology in play here. So if it's something you're interested in or something you want to know more about, let me know and I can help you learn as well as sort out what we have available to work with. As I mentioned during the offering time, this is the time of year when we give back. And we will be collecting funds for the local needy this year. We don't have envelopes because most of us aren't in the physical building. So you can mail a check to the church if you would like for the local needy. Make sure to put in the memo line, funds for local needy. And that way the offering counters will know what to put that money toward. But we always make this push to near the end of the year, and we want to continue to do that this year. I think that's all I have to share with you as we end our service today. And now as you go from this place, go knowing that you are saved by grace. You are justified. You are forgiven. You are sought out, beloved, hidden in Christ, and made for the glory of God. You are known. You are never forsaken. You are held in the palm of God's hand. You are loved. May the peace and power of our God be with us until we gather again. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Our sending song is Your Love Never Fails.
Separate. Even if I ran away, Your love never failed. I know I still make mistakes, but You have new mercies for me every day. Your love never fails. Strong and the water's deep, but I'm not alone here in these open seas. Your love never fails. The chasm is far too wide. I never thought I'd reach the other side. Your love never fails. For my good, You make all things work together for my good. You make all things work together for my good. You make all things work together for my
Go in peace, serve the Lord. Thanks be to God.